What's up, guys? I'm Michael Sasser, boudoir photographer here in Los Angeles, California. And today we're gonna be talking about the five things I would do if I was starting my business from the very beginning, going back in time before I had a logo, before I had a website, before I had shot any boudoir. These are the five things that I would do. Okay, tip number one. If I was starting from the very, very, very beginning, what would be my first step? Actually, it would be pretty similar to how I did first start, which was set up a bunch of photo shoots so I could have examples of my work. But I would have shot even more than I did. So I set up 6 photo shoots in 7 days to build my website. It was great. Then I had 6 different women that I could share on my website. That showed that I had a variety of work and I had photographed a lot of people and it built trust with my future clients. Now you can watch YouTube videos and you can buy courses and you can read online and you can do all the research you want, but no amount of time spent doing that will give you the experience of shooting. My friend Mario says you can't buy the experience of 1,000 photo shoots. And that is so true. The only way to truly improve at your craft is to be doing the actual thing. Is by experiencing that process. This has a couple of bonus benefits. And the first one is that when you're posting, other people will see your work. They will assume you're super busy and therefore really successful and will be much more likely to refer a friend or to book their own shoot or to share your work. And when you're done shooting everybody, ask them for reviews. So then you can put some testimonials up on your website and show that other women have had an amazing client experience with you. Number two, the biggest waste of money that photographers spend when they first start out is on too much gear. I hear people saying, oh, I need the 50mm 1.2 before I can get pictures that look like that. Or I'm thinking of switching my whole camera system so that I can get pictures that look like so-and-so's. If I wasn't recording these videos and I was only shooting boudoir, I would only have one camera body and one lens. It would be something full frame and something 50. This could be a used 6D Mark I with a 50mm 1.8. This could be your old original Canon 5D. This could be pretty much anything. If you're shooting with a DX body, it would be a 35mm 1.8 that would give you about that focal range. And that's the last I would spend on gear for a while. Gear doesn't make you a better photographer. Clients don't know the difference and it won't convince them to spend more money with you. And there are so many more valuable things that you can be spending your money on when you first start. Which brings us to our next tip, which is what is the first thing a photographer should spend money on when they're starting their boudoir business? I believe these three things are the most important things that you can spend money on when you first start. The first one is a brand. So when I first started my boudoir business, my company was just Sasser Stills Wedding Photography. And then I just threw a little boudoir right under that Sasser Stills and just that was my boudoir brand. And nothing about it really said boudoir, it really said weddings. And my website colors and everything was just, it didn't have bite to it, it didn't have an identity. And it certainly wasn't connecting strongly with my clients. So when I moved to LA, I signed up with a website called 99 Designs. So you submit X amount of money, and the more you spend, typically, the more qualified designers will submit to putting together your logo and brand. Then you choose your favorite one, dial it in a little bit more, and that is what got me my logo and brand. Other even more affordable places to go are places like Creative Market for marketing materials and beautiful layouts, and they've got font pairings and it's just gorgeous. You can also check out Fiverr for logo design, for logos for under $100. It's crazy. But having a brand that you stand behind and believe in and shows the quality of the experience that you're giving will absolutely increase your sales. It'll get more clients to you. More people will be able to identify with you and you'll be more easily remembered. The biggest difference between the cost of a Starbucks coffee and the cost of King Soopers coffee is that logo. It's that brand. It's that brand that says this is a premium product. Quality of the coffee, I'll be honest, I don't drink coffee, so I'm not really an expert on the subject. The second thing that I believe you should spend money on are sample albums. You have to show what you want to sell. Write that down. Show what you want to sell. For about $30 to $50, you can get an album from ZNO.com. And for 10 images, you should be able to charge about $300 to $400 to $500 for that album. Now, when a client comes in and they see that album and they flip through the pages and they can imagine their pictures being in it, they are 10 times more likely to buy that album than if they show up and you take pictures and you just say, imagine an album where your pictures are in it and the pages are beautiful and it's leather and it comes in different colors. Would you like to spend $500 on that? It is so much less likely that they will purchase it in that case. So get yourself a sample album. Z&O is a great place to start. It's where I started. I currently use Floracolor USA. They are the best. They do 50% off sample albums. Their customer service is really good. Can't say enough good things about them. I won't bore you, but just please get a sample album. Any sample album. The third thing I would spend money on is education. I mean, colleges are really expensive, but you don't have to do that now. You've got online options, you've got YouTube, you've got blogs, but of course, better education costs more money. There are a few places that I would recommend to check out education for boudoir photography. The first place is Creative Live. There's a few different people who have done Creative Live boudoir courses. The next place is my course. I share so much of my process from start to finish, upselling clients, my 25 best-selling poses. That link is in the description. And a place that I've actually spent money on for education is the Do More Photographer Forum. Now this is put on by some amazing educators and people like me included submit video tutorials every so often on a whole bunch of different topics. So I will link that in the description as well. Okay, the fourth tip. What do I think helped my business grow the most? The first thing is really that I stopped shooting weddings completely. Specializing totally changed my business. It ended up being the only thing that I worked on. It ended up being the only thing I talked about when we discussed what is it that you do. Instead of splitting my time between a bunch of different things, I only spent my time doing one thing, and giving it 100% of my attention really allowed it to grow. The second thing that helped my business grow the most is joining a masterminds group. So there's a lot of Facebook groups with a bunch of different photographers, hundreds of photographers, some thousands of photographers, where you can post a question and get information from a lot of different people. Well, another photographer messaged me and said, hey, I'm putting together this masterminds group, about 4 or 5 photographers. We're gonna do a video chat every 2 weeks. Everybody's gonna take a turn and say what they're working on this week, what didn't work for them this week, and then everybody else can go around and give their feedback, kind of have a discussion about it. That totally skyrocketed my business, and I can't recommend that enough. So, find some photographers, preferably not in your exact same location. Reach out to them, say you wanna have somebody to bounce ideas off of, get a good group together, and plan a weekly or bi-weekly video chat with them so that you guys can discuss what you're working on, hold each other accountable, and seriously grow your business. And the last thing I would say is a little bit more ambiguous, but it's trying to identify why I was so dedicated to boudoir. Like, what about it made me want to give up weddings? What about it did I connect to so much that this was going to be all that I photographed? And if you haven't seen Simon Sinek's Start With Why, I highly recommend it. There's a line in there, a quote in there that I really connected to, is what do you believe that your clients also believe? What do you guys connect on? Man or woman, male or female photographer, what do you believe that your clients also believe? And when you figure this out, instead of just pulling jargon from some other person's website, you will really start to connect with your clients, and that will absolutely increase your bookings and your sales. And last but not least, marketing. So my personal favorite way is SEO, search engine optimization. I'm gonna be honest, I am terrible with search engine optimization. So I outsource it to another business and they put me super high in the search rankings for my area and I'm so grateful. But my real answer to this is to figure out what you are good at. Some people are really good at writing. Some people are really good at speaking on camera. Some people are really good at networking. Some people are really personable. Whichever you are, there's a marketing system that will work best for that. So if you are a much better writer, then spend your time writing blog posts. Spend your time on your website writing copy. Or you can collect emails on your website and then write them email sequences, building the connection between you and them and then asking for them to come in if they're ready, if they connect, if they wanna come in and have their boudoir experience. If you're better at video, put a whole lot of video on your website. Facebook ads can be really effective if that's your cup of tea. I've done Yelp advertising. That was super good for me last year. Pretty terrible for me this year. If you're a social butterfly, get out there and be that social butterfly. Go to networking events, go to local business entrepreneur events, go to mommy and me yoga, go to mixers, go to just get out of the house and go do things, meet people, let them know what you're doing, talk to people, connect with people. Basically, I'm trying to say, find whatever it is you're good at and double down on it. Whew. That was a lot of information. I hope that really helps you guys out. If you're starting out or if you're not starting out, I hope you grabbed a nugget in there. If you like this and wanna see more videos, you know, like this, then if you subscribe, you'll see more videos like this. And I wanna hear from you. What is either the biggest thing you're struggling with in your business, or what is one tip you have for beginner photographers that are just starting their business? All right, that wraps it up for me. I gotta rearrange this studio space because I have somebody coming in for a photo shoot. And if you don't have a photo shoot set up this week, I highly recommend you message somebody, a friend, somebody on Instagram, somebody who follows your work, somebody who's asked to shoot with you, but you've been too busy. Make some time, get out there, go create some content, and keep growing your business.